Hello, I'm Whit Darcy and welcome to the 2012 wash-up for the Sydney Swans. Damien Barrett is with me. And Damo, the Swans would have to be one of the most admired football clubs we've seen at least over the past decade.
Yeah, probably all time, Darcy, when you throw in that last 10 years of what they've done. And there's a permanent resolve to this group, isn't there? And it's no coincidence that they've gone back into another grand final on the very year their GWS teams come into the competition. They're an amazing footy club.
A great culture, haven't they? And they just perform at such a high level. Highlight for me was Lewis Jetta, another player who has thrived in this culture that we talk about. 45 goals for the year so far, heading into a grand final. He is just so exciting. The perfect player that they've wanted Sydney to complement their hard inside midfielders, to get someone who can do this. And you know what I love about him? He's prepared to do it both ways. We've seen some of the great goals of the year from him, but to chase down Paddy Dangerfield, who's probably the second fastest player in the competition. I just love watching this.
Yep.
Eddie Betts is no slouch either. There is no one that comes near him that he doesn't look at and think that he's got covered. Performs his role superbly and just does this all the time. Handballs to himself. No one else I know does that.
Clubs haven't worked him out either, have they, Darcy? It's fair to say.
Well, they might have worked him out, but they haven't got an answer as to how to stop him. And, you know, they're actually orchestrating it really well now, getting him goal side of his opponent. And we saw, you know, one of the great goals of the year was him in the prelim final against Collingwood, running away from Nathan Brown. Your highlight for
my highlight, yeah, it's not a guy who's going to feature in the highlight reels actually too often, but in terms of what he's done over 23 weeks of home and away season and then the 3 weeks of the finals and two games, Josh Kennedy, does just a big man who uses that bulk he's got to his advantage every single time. I'm glad you found a spot for him in the All-Australian on the bench there. He just deserved it. He was very, very good, and he looms as crucial to what happens ultimately for the Swans this year.
Just sensational. One of the great years, contested player. Big unit, bigger than you think. When you see him up close, he's got this big frame, but gets in and does it. Season low light demo for me was around Adam Goods. He got rubbed out twice. It was more just a technique issue. A lot of players were sliding into the contest and super dangerous. We saw Gary Rowan's broken leg for Sydney against North Melbourne. He got rubbed out for a week there and then didn't correct himself and missed a second week with that hit on Jacob Surgeon. And credit to him, he actually was able to correct. In fact, his coach, John Longmire, said, we've got to talk to him about it. And it might end up being a low light into a highlight because he actually missed a few weeks. And heading into the grand final, he's looks fresher than he's ever been, probably because of the fact that he was able to get some games off.
Yep. You touched on the Gary Rowan broken leg from a sliding incident with Lindsay Thomas. Look away now if you don't want to watch this again. But we have to show it. To me, this was their low light. They managed to get to a grand final without this guy, but he was looming as crucial until this round four incident against North Melbourne where Lindsay Thomas came in across the leg. And that is as horrific as you'll ever see in life, let alone footy, when it comes to injuries sustained, us. And I just hope he comes back because he's got massive wraps on him. I just hope it doesn't damage him permanently.
That was me looking away, Damo, because I personally don't like seeing it. He's a great player. Look forward to seeing him come back. Christmas bonus time, Damo. And I'm with you. You stole my thunder a bit on Josh Kennedy. I think he has absolutely warranted a Christmas bonus. Turned into a complete player. Outside chance with the Brownlow. In fact, better than outside chance. He's a good chance. He'll poll really well. Deserved to be an All-Australian. Super story. Can you believe he's going to come up against his old Hawthorn teammates?
Yeah.
The Kennedy name up against the Hawks is just a fascinating story.
Great subplot to the game itself. I'm going to go with Mike Pike, one of your fraternity darts, the big ruckman who you wrote off last year. And you said he was a novelty act, a sideshow. You had no time for him. You weren't at all complimentary. Darcy has been crucial to what's happened to the Swans this year. Crucial.
One of his big fans, as I am. All of the guys that come from outside our code in.
You used the word sideshow at one stage, Darcy.
Far from it. I love what Carmichael Hunt, Israel Folau have done. And I think he could have lobbed it at a dozen other clubs and disappeared into the ether, and we would have thought it was a sideshow. But once again, it's the way Sydney play that enable someone like that to turn into a grand final ruckman and maybe a premiership player come Saturday.
Who are you putting on the chopping block when it comes to the Swans, Darcy?
Never an easy thing to do with a side like this, but I think Jesse White might have found himself out of the side. But at 24 years of age and with his athleticism, can play forward and play ruck. I think there's another home for him. Yep. And maybe that'll end up being a positive story that Sydney will get him to another club. Potentially even Collingwood as a backup ruckman slash key forward, even the mould that Lee Brown played over the past 4 or 5 years. He'll definitely find another time and another home, but maybe it's time to look somewhere else.
Yep. It was an off-season recruiting coup when the Swans got Tommy Walsh out of St Kilda, but just couldn't get a look in, Darcy. Got a look in late in the piece, couldn't hold that spot, and certainly goes out of 2012 into 2013, unsure of where he's at, needs to step up.
Let's have a look at where they need to improve in 2013, if they are to continue to improve. Sam Reed, for me, is a really exciting player. 21 or 22 years of age, got the world in front of him, but getting him from really good player to elite key four, which I absolutely think will happen sooner rather than later, is one of the real keys. They've got Lewis Roberts-Thompson filling in the role, but if Sam Reed becomes a star, they become an unbelievable side.
Yeah, I just think they need a bit more outside polish. I know you waxed lyrical before, and rightly so, on Lewis Jetta. If they can get someone similar to him outside, again, they will continue and sustain where they're at. But their grunt work's unquestioned. Just a little bit more cream on the top, I reckon, be a nice way for the Swans to go.
Where have you got them finishing in 2013?
I've got them stagnating, but when you make a grand final, that's all you need to do, isn't it, Das? Just stay there. And to me, they've just got the system to get themselves into the top four, which is crucial, and then do what they do in finals.
Top four for me. I didn't have them in the top four this year, and you can't do it again for a second time. And they are such a great club, and credit to them the way that they play and the way they handle themselves in general. Well done, Damo. That has been the wash-up for the Sydney Swans in season 2012. Time for the 2012 wash-up for the Hawthorn Football Club, and Damien Barrett is with me. Damo, what a year for the Hawks. They won the minor premiership into a prelim final. Found the going a little bit tough, but they have just been sensational again this year.
Yeah, they have. Started slowly. It's like they built themselves up for a sustained tilt from about halfway through. Early season form, it wasn't crash hot, but I think hindsight says, and even at the time, we knew what they were doing. They were just timing their run, and as you say, a little hiccup nearly in the prelim final, but hit the last day of the calendar in good form.
Lots of highlights this year for the Hawks. None bigger for me than Buddy Franklin's 13-goal effort against North Melbourne. He was just incredible. We talk about how hard it is to kick bags of goals. And up until then, his form was being questioned a little bit, but as the champs do, responded. This is goal number 12 on the boundary. 6 foot six, you're not supposed to be able to do that. And when he gets going, kicking the ball in that way, 5 seconds to go, 12 goals. Ball comes down and Buddy kicks a massive bag of 13, which was just a brilliant highlight for me for the year for the Hawks.
Yeah, I couldn't disagree with that at all, Dars. To me, I'm going to give it to Jared Ruffhead. I know he's probably past month has been down, but just getting back from that horrific Achilles injury that he sustained last year, and this is his first game back this year, and you can see how much it meant to his teammates to have him back. Played a great role, didn't he? The reluctant ruckman who became a crucial part of that club by playing as a backup ruckman, kept Bailey out of the team in so doing and worked really well with Hale throughout the year. And while his form in recent weeks has been slightly down on what he showed up until the final started, still remains very crucial as to what's going to happen on the weekend.
Always get nervous with an Achilles tendon injury, Damo. I'm told that almost harder to come back from than a knee reconstruction. And you had your heart in your mouth a little bit with his return, but he has been fantastic. Well done. Let's have a look at a low light in season 2012, Damo.
Yeah, this was the Guerrera. This is the injuries late in the year to you know, key players, Dars. And I know you want to talk about Guerrera and Whitecross in the qualifying final going down as well.
Yeah, I think they're going to be the heartbreak stories if they are to go through and win the grand final on Saturday against the Swans. There'll be, you know, two really shattered players. That is a low light but a highlight because Brendan Whitecross, I thought his demeanour and the way he actually actively tried to not show, you know, the hurt that he was feeling was a real tragedy. And Brent Guerrera, I really feel for. He's a gun. He's absolutely in their best 18. And if he isn't to get up for the grand final, that's a real low-light. Low-light for you?
It's just the whole Buddy Franklin saga when he did his hamstring that became a one-week injury, as the Hawks told us at the time. It became six. Within that six-week time frame, there were all sorts of stuff being said. Nasty stuff, bad stuff, wrong stuff. But he also went through that driving incident in that time frame too, Dars. And also he had a fit at home, which was also the cause for one of those weeks being missed. Really ugly saga for him, but got through. And in hindsight, the 6 weeks he missed because that hamstring has served him well for the year.
Let's hand out a Christmas bonus for the Hawthorn Football Club in 2013. And maybe surprisingly for a few, Ryan Shellmakers, who has had a couple of issues in the big finals, but I think he's gone from a defender that everyone's tried to isolate, pretty much the whipping boy for Hawthorn, to a really reliable.
So you're giving
solid
him the
player.
Christmas bonus.
Yeah, happy to do that because what you've got to do with the list is work with the talent that you've got. Not the most talented player. In fact, you'd probably be right down the bottom 40 on their list in terms of talent.
But really? Yep.
The way that he has performed with his ability, this was just a brilliant moment in a big game against the West Coast Eagles to chase Jack Darling down and do it. I reckon he gives all. He still has some trouble with being isolated, but for effort, I think Ryan Schoenmakers has had a really good year.
Very generous to us. His pay would have been docked had they missed the grand final on the back of that free kick late in the game in the prelim final.
They didn't, and they're in a grand final, Dame, and that's all that you can
hey, I'm, go this vision is too good not to use, so therefore I'm going to give the Christmas bonus when it comes to Hawthorn to this plasterer here at the MCG who had to fix up this mess that Alistair Clarkson did in one of his regular rants to us. He was off again on the weekend.
He gave it a good whack, didn't he?
He would have broken his wrist, Darcy, if he hit a beam, I reckon.
You know, I love Xavier Ellis on the other side of the box, just didn't want to look over his shoulder. He's seen a bit of Clarko rage before, but... all's well that ends well. No damage done. The coaches are allowed to show a bit of emotion. Chopping block, always a hard thing to do, particularly with a side that's played against Hawthorn. But there's one for me, I think. Michael Osborne, 31 years of age, coming back from a knee reconstruction. It's going to be hard going. Been a great player, one of those players that is loved by his teammates. I'm not sure that he's going to be able to hang on for another year.
Yeah, it's harsh, isn't it? And as you say, when you make a grand final, there's not too much has gone wrong. I'm putting Tommy Murphy on only because I just think he's a player who could play 22 games at another club. He missed out in 08. Could miss out again into 2012 by just way of team balance and team selection. He's done well to play the two final starts and did really well on the weekend, but I think someone's got to make way for Hodge to come back into that team. Unfortunately, I think it's going to be him. And even then, if he does play, I think he's better off at another club, just personally speaking, to get a full quota of matches in.
Let's have a look to next year, Damo. What do you think the Hawks need to do if they are to improve?
Not much, Darcy. I just think they just need to hold it together. They've got it right this year. I reckon when I say the same, just do the same, because if they do the same again, they will guaranteed make a prelim final again, and then it's just a matter of getting their minds right, which is the issue at hand for Hawthorn.
Yeah, likewise for me, they just need to stay injury-free and keep that quality list together, and it's going to be a formidable side again next year. Where have you got them finishing in 2013?
I'm going to put them straight into the grand final again next year, Darcy. I know that's a long way away, but I reckon they're good enough to be locked in for that status already.
Yeah, something untoward would have to happen for Hawthorn to slide down the ladder. It would have to be serious injury, and that's the only uncertainty. If everything stays even, scarily, I think they can actually improve and develop. They're still young enough to do that. Nice work, Damo. That has been the wash-up for the Hawthorn Football Club in season 2012.